Well, Skippy the Kangaroo was Australia's first international television star, with her bizarre abilities to play the piano, use a screwdriver, drive a car and speak Italian. Well, 50 years later, the show's still running somewhere in the world, and now the National Film and Sound Archive has compiled an online exhibit about our favourite marsupial.
She could start cars, play marbles, and bang out Happy Birthday on the goanna. She could hypnotise Sonny. Loved a punt on the nags.
3-1 Wallaby Bill.
And knew her screwdrivers.
Screwdriver, Skip, the small one.
And since the series ended in 1969, after 3 years and 91 stories about Sonny and his mate, someone somewhere on the planet has been watching Skippy the Bush Kangaroo, except Sweden.
Their psychologists thought that it was wrong to mislead children into believing that animals could do things that they really couldn't do.
Even though Skip was learning Italian,
buongiorno, signore.
The series would eventually be dubbed into 28 languages, with an audience of hundreds of millions. The show's writers crafting Antipodean adventures to a tightly held formula, including no Aussie slang.
So this again pointed to the fact that they were aiming at the international market for the series.
Mind you, the late great John Mellion gave it a red hot.
Have you lost anything, mister?
No. I was just seeing that the milk and honey was in the sky.
So, Skippy, haven't you, Skip?
Oh!
Skippy would create a marketing maelstrom.
Try the fresh new taste of Skippy cornflakes.
Daddy eating us cornflakes ever made.
Including a fan club.
I know that you'll be proud to wear this Skippy badge and carry your official membership card.
And the first celebrity in-store appearances. This in Newcastle.
She was standing with a lead and collar on, just absolutely mobbed by parents and children. She didn't seem very ruffled by all of the adulation that was coming her way. She really was very much loved.
An online exhibit of Skippy's televisual history, now compiled by the National Film and Sound Archive, includes rare outtakes from production. And of course, there is much of Skip talking with Ranger Matt and family.
What is it, Skip?
Well, what's wrong, Skip?
Where's Sonny, Skip?
And this is despite kangaroos not making the noise. Dubbed later, which meant making her mouth move.
They would get her to eat grass where she had to chew it, or chocolate, or even chewing gum.
But she could still play drums, operate an encrypted BlackBerry, and had a coffee addiction. Okay, I made up the last two, but it seemed that anything was possible for Skippy the Bush Kangaroo. The exhibit is on the Film and Sound Archives website.
See you, Skip!
Mike Dalton, Nine News.